According to the proposed statutory instrument, the government has capped fees for pre-primary schools at 690,000 shillings per term, with day primary schools not to exceed 650,000 shillings in both fees and other charges, and boarding primary schools not to charge more than 1.2 million shillings per term. For secondary level, boarding section will pay 1.6 million in fees and other charges. The move has since attracted mixed reactions. School owners have also come out to condemn the proposal, saying it only means to suppress the private education institutions.
Where should we get this money? When you bring a new curriculum, we are talking about skilling. What are we going to use to skill? Are these meager resources able to take us through? What is the mission of government? What is the purpose of government? What is the importance of liberalization? How are you controlling other sectors? So we think there is a move that is aimed towards crushing the private sector. Government should clearly come out and tell us we don't need any more investment in education, because serious investors are going to run out.
It would be a bias and a sabotage of investment codes and interest of fighting illiteracy in this community. The basis of educating is giving, expanding the knowledge, skilling the individuals or Ugandans who have not accessed this right in other institutions. Relating to the population, we have over 18,000 institutions. You realize that the government will never, it has never had, it has no, and will never have capacity to absorb the population of Uganda.
They say the move is a true contradiction to government's move to liberalize the education sector, besides many schools are still struggling to get back on their feet after they were severely hit by the COVID-19 pandemic. Also, many of them say the tough economic times have forced many schools to hike their dues due to match the current economic trends.
Why do schools increase fees? Everyone must understand the fluctuation challenges. The prices are fluctuating daily. On the consumables, the price of maize, flour, beans, and scholastic materials, petroleum, tend to increase more than double. As of this season, they increased more than double. The report, the annual report on food crop inflation, as indicated from the WUBOS report of 2022, it will still indicate to you that inflation stood at 14.5%.
These also gave a number of recommendations that the government can undertake to regulate the education sector rather than dictating the school fees.
If we are partnering with government, government should seem to be understanding us. And government, through the policies, it would bring policies that are supporting the industry, that enable an environment that enable the sector to grow. We have injected in effort. We are contributing to our country, Uganda. We are investing. We are the only investors, painfully, who are truly Ugandan. The Ugandan education sector investment is purely Ugandan. We employ Ugandan. The people who are in school, majority are Ugandans. We are never given land free like other investors.
Under the proposed statutory instrument, the Education Ministry has also set the standard mechanisms for how fees will be determined or reviewed by a school. In all these schools, owners claim they were not consulted despite being present in that meeting. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.